Good evening, everybody. My name is John, and this is Dave, who's in our studio audience. Dave wants to work in television, so we thought he could introduce this special compilation episode of the Recommended Daily Allowance Week 1. Dave?
This is the best of Recommended Daily Allowance for the week from the 3rd to the 6th of July. Hope you enjoy it. BBC Choice.
Thank you. God bless you all for being so drunk. Thank you very much indeed. And welcome to the programme. Good evening. This is your Recommended Daily Allowance. My name is John. Today is July the 4th, American Independence Day, so-called because on this day, 5 years ago, the film Independence Day was released. And now what's... Oh, I see, that's blocking something. All right. Glaring. All right. Someone in the audience was glaring, apparently. So please, if you could just stop that business right now. This is a comedy show, for goodness sake. Get the message. This we saw earlier today. We have no idea what it means, but we thoroughly enjoy looking at it. It's great fun. Some kind of Zimbabwe Millennium Wheel. That's the best we could come up with. But it's very, very entertaining. What happened? Oh, he fell over. He rolled over. But the big news was, of course, last night. Did you see it? Were you watching? It was a big deal. I was very excited. My girlfriend was away for the weekend, and I got a couple of crates of beer and ordered a few pizzas, got the lads over, and settled down to watch the final night of BBC Choice's coverage of Gay Mardi Gras Weekend. It really was wonderful. All right, well, obviously, it was, of course, the big final of Euro 96. And a lot of people in the office have been joking about how little I know about football, and you know, just because I backed Brazil for the tournament, which hardly seems fair. But don't get me wrong, I enjoy the game as much as the next woman. In fact, I have been glued to this tournament, and I think my favourite part of it had to be John Motson's pre-match commentary last night. Let's have a quick look at that.
We spare a passing thought as we look at the teams coming out for the devastated Dutch hosts, the protesting Portuguese, the sporadic Spaniards, even the disappointing Danes, the negative Norwegians and the stereotyped Swedes. And if the Germans were bordering on the geriatric, the Romanians were refreshing, the Slovenians surprising, and the Turks tenacious. No joy, though, for the cheerful Czech Republic, the brittle Belgians, nor, sadly, for the empty-handed England team or the empty-headed louts who tried to spoil the fun but failed.
There you go. Who knows? John Motson, obviously some kind of mnemonic device that he uses to remember the teams. I don't know. You know something? When you're putting together a nightly comedy show that aims to capture the spirit of a generation, you learn how important it is to create a comfortable office environment where staff can work happily and contentedly. Because there's one thing that we've learned, gentlemen, our actual genuine studio audience members, the show that you create offstage is reflected in the show that you see on stage, or in this case, on screen. Gentlemen, I had no idea I'd be sitting amongst you as I did this, but it feels appropriate. Are you enjoying the programme, by the way? How far have your standards slipped? It's fun in an odd sort of quite a long way. It's sort of like magic eye television, isn't it? If you just relax and defocus your eyes, then eventually sort of jokes do emerge, though, don't they? Anyways, the first thing we did when we got into... This is like some great piece of homo television. Me and my boys. The first thing we did, basically, when we come in, we've got a crappy old sofa out there, and we looked at some catalogues for mail order sofas, and look, this is what we found. Here are some of the sofas that we looked through them all. What's that? Klandau, Rimini, Triorchi. Anyway, we looked through all these brochures, and it seems that for some reason, all mail order sofas come from South Wales. We actually proved this. We were shocked. We have no idea. Were you aware of this statistic?
No.
All right. Well, it's fascinating. Look, we have here, look, a sofa map of South Wales, because we really just have far too much time on our hands. And if you don't believe us, I think Jonathan Spencer, our graphics man, has expressed that statistic in the form of a bar chart. There you go. And... thank you. And just in case you're not convinced, here it is in convenient word form. There you go. So, a couple of weeks ago, we took a trip to South Wales to find out why, and it seems, looking back on it, that we spent all day bumping into things and getting things wrong. How could that happen on a programme like this? But let's look at the Welsh Sofas videotape and find out if memory serves us right. We're running. We've come here because it seems to be the centre of sofa production in Wales, and also, more importantly, it's the only Welsh name that we can pronounce. Bride End.
Sofa, please don't leave me so far. Though I look elsewhere and found a chair, I still love you.
Right, so we finally got here to Classic Choice, which is what this programme will be on one day. We think now we have got the right place, because there's a Mr. DK Hobbs parking space, so we'll just go in and see what's going on. Hello! Are you Derek?
You're Rob. No, you're Rob. I'm Derek.
No, I'm John. He's Rob.
Rob.
Rob's over there. Derek?
I'm Derek. You're John.
I'm John.
How are you doing?
Let's hug.
Yes, how are you, John?
So this is where it starts, really. This is... Right. We get orders in, individual orders.
Do I have hat hair? Is it all right?
Yeah.
Okay. You know why we're here, don't you, first of all?
About the preponderance of furniture companies in the South Wales area.
It is a preponderance. Yeah. How come?
Basically, it harks back to a company called Christie Tyler, which started up during the war, had an upholstery factory after the war, and he made a difference to the upholstery trade, and they produced at one time a group more than 16,000 briefing suits a week.
Are there dirty tricks, or are there things that people do that are a little underhand? Or...
There are people out there who claim to be manufacturers selling direct, and they don't. They import leather furniture from China,
right?
Cheap leather furniture. Say they make it, but they don't. There are also other people that buy from other manufacturers and claim it's selling direct.
Right.
So it's important, I think, to differentiate those between the ones who actually make the furniture and sell it, and the ones who buy it and sell it.
Right. Why don't we use this as an opportunity to send a message out to those people?
Mm.
Why don't we just say, is there something you could say?
I'd say that, yeah, there are two things to be careful of, really. One way to check that somebody who claims to be a manufacturer is actually manufacturing is ask them to interchange fabrics. If they actually buy from different manufacturers, they won't be able to interchange fabrics or leathers on the different pieces they sell. If the manufacturer, they should be within technical limits, able to swap around fabrics to the customer's choice.
Mm. Right.
See.
That's fine. I'm overriding the mixture.
Yeah.
So what have we got? We've got the Claudia.
Right. Removable cover model.
Do you think it's right to call herself a Claudia?
Why not?
Why? Why is it called Claudia?
It's one of the biggest problems we have is deciding on a name for these models, because they bear no relationship whatsoever to an actual models at all.
Right. How much does it cost? Do you get it for the normal?
I'll get it for trade price.
The mayor's here. Hello?
Hello, Derek Hobbs.
Aye. So you're to do the firm then?
That's right, yeah.
There we are.
We thought...
You were holding back then. There we are. You were saying?
So what we thought we would do is should we just have a coffee?
Coffee and a tea. Who wants...
The mayor gets this cup with a gold rim on it.
There's no sugar in there, though, so...
Would you like a coffee, Aaron?
No, all right. Fine,
anybody coffee? All right. You will. All right. That's all right. Let me show you something, because this now, what we've done is we've compiled a little videotape compilation of summit leaders, world leaders, sitting on sofas.
As my daddy was killed.
Now, what's your, Derek, what do you think of the sofa?
I think it sums up a sort of pre-war Yugoslavian suite. That's probably all they got left after the troubles.
It's Albanian, not bad.
Yeah.
What do you think about the nap on that?
I mean, obviously the buttons have fallen off it.
Upward nap or downward nap?
Downward nap.
What I spot there is something, a pattern that's very similar to something that my wife, myself, bought when we got married, first of all.
Right.
But that sofa would never be used other than in the parlour. That's a good thing.
That's a good moment, isn't
it? Has he sold him the sofa? You see, because I'm not commercially a magician, I do it for my charities.
Could we come to your house and watch you do some magic?
Yes, certainly, yes. Okay. I've had people from other parts of the world come. There's no reason why you shouldn't come.
Well, thank you.
Hello, boys and girls.
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor.
Pardon?
Good afternoon, Mr. Mayor.
Oh, that's good. Can you tell me, right. What have we got here? We've got a magic hat. No, right? Good. And there's your magic wand. Okay. And here we have a bag that's completely empty. Okay? Now then, do you like silks? Do you like silks? Yes.
Mr. Good. Mayor, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm enjoying the magic and everything, but I'm afraid.
You've got to go.
Okay.
Cheerio.
Bye-bye.
All the best.
I'm so stupid. There's something I've got to do. Derek. Yes, Lord. There are mountains that I will, but we climb a step every day. For most city dwellers, of course, there are few more reassuring and uplifting sights than the civic monuments and statues which provide us with a link to past traditions and grander times. But tonight we premiere a powerful short film which tells an altogether different story. So now, for the first time on television, be warned, this may disturb and confuse, a short film entitled When Monuments Swear. It's absolutely puerile. This is a very interesting one for us. Our guest is a former Bond girl, and you may have seen her in the recent reissue of Get Carter. So would you please welcome very warmly to the stage Britt Eklund, please. Hello. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
It's quite a night. Please welcome Mr. Paul Foote.